So you've probably already heard that hyaluronic acid occurs naturally in the skin and attracts 1,000 times its weight in water, and it's found in almost every skincare ingredient. If that's really the case, then why is my skin still dry, still needs hydration, and isn't really that plump? Could it be that hyaluronic acid is backfiring? After all, it is a humectant. It's supposed to decrease fine lines and wrinkles and soothe the skin out. So why is that not happening? In this video, we'll go over the three problems of hyaluronic acid and an ingredient that might be even better when it comes to hydration and dry skin. So definitely stay tuned till the end. Also, real quick before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on next to it to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Hyaluronic acid is a glycosaminoglycan, unfortunately known as a GAG. Yeah, not the nicest name for it, but it's naturally found in the extracellular matrix of almost every cell in your body. It's a linear polysaccharide, which means it's made up of repeating sugar units bound together. Think of it as a sugary carb. Also, what most people don't know is that it's a cushion and a lubricant in the joints and other tissues in the body because it's really good at trapping water inside tissue cells. But age and environmental factors will naturally slow that production down in the body, leaving fine lines and wrinkles and less shock absorption in the joints. But in skincare, you find it has many names: hydrolyzed hyaluronic acid, or sometimes sodium hyaluronate, which is the salt derived from hyaluronic acid. And despite its having its name as an acid, it doesn't exfoliate, but what it does do is soak water up. So think of it as a sponge on your face for water. So then what's the problem? Shouldn't it work if it's a sponge? Here's the first problem: the architecture of hyaluronic acid. And what do I mean? If you lose hyaluronic acid, let's say by aging, think of it like this. Just like you can't replenish a loss of collagen stores by pushing collagen cream into your face or strengthen your bones by pushing a calcium cream onto them, it's the same with hyaluronic acid. The hyaluronic acid has a very large molecular size and can't go through the top layer of the skin. This is why hyaluronic acid injectable filler was created in the first place, because the molecules are too big to sink through the skin naturally. All the natural hyaluronic acid that's already in your skin is found in the dermis, the deeper layer located here. The upper layer of the epidermis has very little hyaluronic acid. It really only shows up if there's a cut and the skin needs to close that cut up. And the hyaluronic acid that the body has is way different than what's in your skincare products. The holding the 1,000 times its weight in water is how the body's version does that. There doesn't seem to be any available studies that show the products you use actually do that. Peter Thomas Roth actually got sued because their products advertised that it did, when there's no solid proof of that. That's because hyaluronic acid is in skincare thankfully doesn't come from human tissue, even though it did come from umbilical cords back in the day. It usually comes from microbial fermentation these days. So that's the first issue. It struggles to get into the dermis, even the hydrolyzed forms. There's no solid proof that it holds 1,000 times its weight in water, and it's not the same hyaluronic acid that's in the body. So those are the architectural issues. The second is that it actually dehydrates the skin, especially if your skin is already dehydrated to begin with, and if the air is dry. What ends up happening is that it actually sucks water from deeper in the skin and has an opposite effect, leaving the skin drier and even thirstier. There's this idea that if you live in an area with low humidity, 30% or less, the hyaluronic acid will draw moisture from your skin instead of the air, leading to dryness. But here's the catch. It's going to pull from the nearest source, which is your skin, not the air. The benefit of that is that it temporarily makes the skin look smooth and hydrated. But what happens when all that moisture evaporates? Your skin gets dehydrated. It's kind of like licking your lips when they are chapped. It's great for a few minutes. They feel hydrated, but then it goes back to being chapped. It's only temporary. So that's the second problem. The third problem is you still need to use it in conjunction with other moisturizers. This is because hyaluronic acid isn't a moisturizer. It's a plumper. It was never really a moisturizer to begin with. One way to circumvent the problem is by applying it on damp skin, then using hyaluronic acid, then sealing it with a moisturizer. The moisturizer will help seal hydration into the skin and help the hyaluronic acid absorb correctly. Although this may work great for some people and people do get benefits from doing it in this method, I have to let you in on why this may not be the best idea either. Think back to what hyaluronic acid is, right? It's a sugar. Yeah, it's a billion-dollar business and it's in almost every product, even in sunscreen. But most importantly, it's a sugar. Theoretically, what you could be doing without even knowing is feeding this sugar to a type of fungus that's naturally found on your skin, dermatophytes. Once they eat up the sugars, they'll secrete an enzyme that breaks down your skin barrier. And when you have a compromised skin barrier, you'll have a number of different other problems arising. And I made a video on repairing skin barrier, which I encourage you to watch after this one. So now that we got through the three big problems with hyaluronic acid, what would be the alternative if you wanted to switch for something else? You can try polyglutamic acid. As it was reported in this study that polyglutamic acid had moisturizing effect and skin elasticity more than collagen and hyaluronic acid, which is really interesting. It can be used both morning and night, and it can pair well with vitamin C serums. It also helps to stop the action of hyaluronidase, which is the enzyme that breaks down hyaluronic acid, so it results in more hyaluronic acid in the skin naturally. And I left my favorite one in the description below if you wanted to check it out. And I get it. The skin doesn't take in skincare products as easily as it should sometimes, and it becomes more irritated when you try too many products, and can sometimes take about a month or longer for the skin to repair itself when it gets dehydrated from humectants. And the thing is, when we're younger, the skin takes about 28 days to renew itself, but this slows down to 70 days when we get older. So it does get tricky. And if that's the case, then you could also try glycerin, as it's a favorite alternative to hyaluronic acid by so many. And some even prefer it over any other humectant, which you can also find in the description box down below. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts about this? Leave them in the comments below. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.